Hello everyone, I'm Jeff Thomson, President and CEO of the Institute of Management Accountants, and it's a pleasure to be here. This is the series for the future, part two. If you recall, we did part one, where we focused generally on artificial intelligence and various technologies and their impact on the profession. So here we're going to continue that conversation about all these new technologies that we're hearing about day by day, and how they will impact the profession, the risk they create for the profession, but also the opportunity and the call to action for the profession. But secondly, I'll also be specifically speaking to the market in India as it relates to all of these topics. And the reason that we're talking about India is very simple. I just came back from a 8-day, 5-city strategic trip to India. Very anxious to share some of what I learned as it relates to technology, automation, and competency. As I was there in India, we were very pleased and proud to learn that IMA reached the 100,000 member milestone for the first time in its history as we approach 100 years of service to mission and service to the profession. So let's talk a little bit about India, the market. India, as I'm sure you know, is a vast, vast country, a beautiful culture. The time of year I went was very seasonable, which is nice. I happen to like spicy food, which is nice. Just a beautiful culture full of diversity. From an economic perspective, India is one of the BRICS countries, which you might recall as Brazil, Russia, India, China, and some years ago, South Africa was added. And, you know, the BRICS countries are, you know, were meant to be the emerging economies. Of course, they've had their ups and downs. But, you know, India, in terms of its GDP, is growing at about 7 or 7.5% GDP, which is very, very good. They're the seventh largest economy in the world in measured in real GDP. And some would say over the next three decades that they could actually become the second largest economy in the world. So this is a vast, vast market with a lot of opportunity. So now that we've broadly spoken about India, the market, let's speak a little bit about India and technology. You know, India has really transformed itself. About 61% of the GDP in India is generated through services, and the other 39% is manufacturing. So they have really, really evolved to a services environment. I'm told, and I believe anecdotally this is correct, 40% of the world's data scientists reside in India. And finally, India is one of the world's leading exporters of IT services, valued at over $100 billion. So in terms of my observations on India and automation, I visited about 15 corporations ranging from multinational companies to private family-run businesses to national India type of companies, and they really are making a lot of advances in automation. For example, Mahindra Group, the large auto conglomerate in India, has worked in the past with IBM Watson on streamlining and simplifying its supply chain and the user experience using blockchain technology. Many of the corporations I spoke to during my 8-day, 5-city strategic visit talked about implementing bots or machine learning or cognitive computing right inside their financial processes, whether it's audit or transaction processing. One company that I met with, the learning and development folks, we had a robust conversation on moving away from PowerPoints and video in our learning delivery to gamification and virtual reality and augmented reality. So there's so much going on in India, the government level, spurring and funding entrepreneurial innovation. It really, really is amazing and very, very inspiring in many ways. So now let's turn to the risks of all that we're seeing here with the various types of technologies. The first thing from a risk perspective is to understand that many of these technologies are not emerging, they're here today. And also that they're beginning to impact our profession in a significant manner. So we talk about artificial intelligence and robotics process automation and cognitive computing, machine learning. All of these technologies are here today, and not just in manufacturing, but in services. As I mentioned before, they're beginning to impact financial transaction processing and the audit process. In fact, many of the Big Four are working with IBM Watson to streamline their auditing function. There have been some studies that indicate that in India, about 69% of all jobs are subject to automation and cannibalization and possibly replacement and displacement of jobs. So I choose not necessarily to look at this as a risk, but turning risk into opportunity and seizing the opportunity in our great profession. But it's going to require a greater sense of urgency and a call to action for our great profession of finance and accounting professionals in India and around the world. So my first point is that automation, displacement, replacement of more routine, repeatable tasks and jobs is actually a good thing. As CFOs in industry and F&A professionals or finance and accounting professionals, it's in our best interest to help drive operational efficiency. Operational efficiency means stronger, more robust, financially disciplined organizations that can invest in a great people, in people, processes, and technology. Now, you might say, well, why isn't there a risk in India, for example, if nearly 70% of the jobs in our profession or generally can be automated? Well, let's look at it this way and let's turn more to the opportunity. I believe that if we're able to develop competencies in the areas of data science and data analytics and infuse them more into our competency frameworks and curricula for our profession, we could actually replace those displaced jobs and create many more value-added types of jobs. And I had this conversation with literally thousands of folks in India, in corporates, in academia, members from our various chapters in the various regions. And we all generally and directionally agree, but we have to take action now. You know, our profession is known for a lot of things that we should be very proud of: our commitment to ethics, to integrity, to values, to safeguarding of assets, internal controls, and the list goes on and on. But being a little bit of a self-assessment here, I also believe that our profession is not necessarily known for its agility and its adaptability to change. And if we're going to get ahead of all this disruption and the fact that some jobs are going to leave our profession, this is all about our reputation as a profession, our relevance going forward as influential business partners. Am I suggesting that all finance and accounting professionals need to become advanced level statisticians and econometricians? No. Am I saying in India and elsewhere that the status quo is okay? Absolutely not. I do believe that there are competencies in data science and data analytics that we must infuse, as I mentioned, into our competency frameworks and into our undergraduate F&A curricula now. For example, data analytics, data mining, business intelligence. Of course, human judgment and critical thinking are going to be absolutely key. You know, robotics and machine learning and cognitive computing obviously have broadened the scope and scale of what they can do and think and adapt, but I think there's still going to be a place for quite a long time for judgment, critical thinking, but we have to be fueled and powered by data science and data analytics. IMA is doing its part in defining specific competencies that we believe will help propel our profession to a great and prosperous future. So thank you for the time. I look forward to further engagement with you in this series for the future series. Thank you very much.